So what we're talking about today is women's self-protection for women, because we get a lot of questions about, you know, what if they're smaller, what if it's a big dude, you know, what you should and shouldn't do, or I've heard this, or I've seen that, this, that, and the other. And we're going to address some of those things right here in this mini-series for you, and, you know, hopefully it makes sense. We do have an online learning program, which I highly recommend you to check out. It's not just for dudes like myself, bigger guys. It's also for women, and you can learn anything. But what we're going to introduce here is a bit of a, well, it's an introductory course, you know, to try and help you understand the logic behind combatives, because it's not self-defense, it's self-protection, something that we do. You know, so it's always proactive, it's not reactive. And as I just said, there's logic behind it. So as always, we're looking for efficiency. You know, what's simplest? You know, how can we achieve our goal as quickly as possible? You know, so minimum effort, maximum effect. So stay with us as we look at some of the most common scenarios that you're going to encounter out there in the real world. Okay, so what we're looking at in this first introduction is why you shouldn't punch. Now, women train to punch. Can you just show me your right hand for me? Show me your right hand. Look at that right hand. That's pretty mangled up from a week of hitting pads, isn't it?
First day. Yeah. This is like
since last Sunday. So because we don't train with gloves. If you wear gloves and you wear wraps and you're wrapping your head up all the time, you can see other videos we talked about it, you're not doing your hands any good, because someone's head, for one, isn't as soft as a focus mid training pad, and you're not going to be wearing gloves on the street. That's where you're going to encounter something, right? Or in a bar or whatever. So I don't recommend you punch unless you train to punch and you train combatives with us the way that we do it, because that's as realistic as you can possibly get. You can see why if you look at other stuff. Now, one of the parts of your hand that's incredibly hard to break is this part here that, you know, it's like you're holding something like a knife and it's just like stabbing. You know, any of the motions that we have with our hammer fists here can be adapted for if you're carrying a weapon. And that is applicable to a lot of you watching this, I'm sure. So, what we're going to look at is being preventative. Okay, so a lot of people, a lot of women ask me, she's already ready, as you can see, hard target this one. She's not going to wait to be grabbed, she's not going to be waiting until a punch or anything is coming. As soon as I approach her, we're going to get her to sort of take a neutral stance. I'm not a believer in the, hey, look out, I watch, no, watch out, I look, I can do karate, kind of string a fucking sentence together. But my point is that as she's coming, if she's looking kind of casual but have some sort of body language that isn't so inviting like this, like she's paying attention and she's protecting her vitals just like this, for example, she's like that. What she can do from there is exactly what we're about to show you, and that is put out that reference hand. Okay, so to affect my balance, make me look away and drop that hammer fist. Okay, and then what? What do we do?
Step back.
There you go, good. So, we do it at normal speed now, so I approach her. As soon as I'm too close, within her personal space.
Step back.
There you go, and she rocks it. Let's go from the other side. So, one more time, I get within her personal space.
Step back.
You see that? She just adjusted it anyway, so I got too close for her to even get her hand in my face, so she bumped me first, I come back, then what, she puts that front hand out, straight into my face, gives me that shot, bang, dropping that hammer fist. Look, I'm 6'5", how tall are you? You're 152 centimeters.
Yeah, about 5'2".
5'2", about 5'2", so there's like a foot and whatever difference, right? So she can still reach my face, you know what I mean? She could reach the groin before that. What if the guy's bigger? We'll address that next, but this is why you don't punch, and what you can do instead of punching. Of course, there's elbows, there's knees, there's headbutts. We're going to introduce that for you very soon. Stay with us.
Three!